Update your Ruckus. GitHub improves open source repo security, and Discord discloses a data breach. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire from May 16th, 2023. This is your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. Let's go ahead and jump right into the news this week. Heads up, Ruckus wireless AP owners, a new malware botnet is targeting unpatched devices to turn them into bots for their DDoS campaigns. The malware is called Andoryu Bot, and the vulnerability it's targeting has to do with admin panels that have not been updated to versions newer than 10.4. Now, this flaw gives attackers the ability to send unauthenticated HTTP GET requests to the device in order to do remote code execution attacks. It was first discovered on February 8th, 2023, and fixed on the same day. According to Ruckus's security bulletin, the CVE is tracked as CVE-2023-25717 with a 9.8 severity score, so it's pretty high up there. It originates from improper handling of HTTP requests, and while it was already patched in February, that month many devices still remain vulnerable to this day, and end-of-life devices will not receive a patch at all. Fortinet shared that the newest version of the botnet started targeting Ruckus products specifically in April. So Fortinet explains that the newest version contains DDoS attack modules, which communicate with the attacker-owned CNC server via SOX 5 proxies. Once the malware finds a vulnerable device, it downloads a script for further propagation, and it is very stealthy and it can bypass firewalls. The attackers are using this flaw to make their botnet bigger, obviously, and they are selling DDoS for higher services. Now, Ruckus recommends users install the firmware updates, set up strong admin passwords, and disable the remote admin panel if it's not necessary for your needs. CISA has also added this flaw to their known exploited vulnerabilities last week, and they are requiring federal agencies to patch by June 2nd. GitHub is now releasing a security feature called Push Protection after it entered a testing phase about a year ago. This will be available to all public repositories for free, and it was created to help developers from accidentally leaking private keys or secrets in code. Now, this will work hand in hand with another feature that's already implemented in GitHub. This one is called Secret Scanning, which scans repos for commonly used secret formats. Push Protection looks for leaks of secret data, and when found, a dev will be prompted and recommendations will be shown. Now, this can be bypassed or skipped if the secret is there for a reason, so a developer can pinpoint if it's written into code for testing, if it was a false positive, or if it's something that's considered an acceptable risk. But the admins for the repository will be notified of whatever choice is made via email. Now, this does have to be enabled via the settings under Code Security and Analysis. You can then choose to enable secret scanning and push protection. According to GitHub's numbers, the beta, which was first released in April of last year, had so far prevented 17,000 secret leaks, and it saved over 95,000 hours of work doing things like rotating secret keys that accidentally might have gotten leaked if this wasn't in place. Now, this is made to be a frictionless experience for developers, and now that it's available for public repositories as well as private ones, it will be a very positive way to help open source software be more secure. Biggest of shoutouts to my Patreon supporters, especially my golden s'mores and their fur babies, they're so cute, for making this show possible since we don't have ads on the show at all, except for Patreon. And a big thank you to everyone for being a part of the s'mores over at patreon.com/ShannonMorse. That is my new Patreon page for the show, where I will be posting all of the perks for patrons, including early access to this video. If you are currently a patron on the ThreatWire page, you can simply switch on over to the new page so you don't lose access to any of your perks, including this early access. Let's go ahead and finish out today's episode with my last top story all about Discord. And a shout out to Joel over on Patreon for sharing this story with me. Discord started notifying some users about a data breach that affected one of their third-party agents' support ticketing queue. That means that some customer service messages, email addresses, along with attachments that may have been included in these messages sent to customer support, were possibly affected and exposed. Discord said they immediately deactivated the compromised account and they did a malware check on the affected machine. Discord said they worked with the customer service partner to, quote, improve practices and help prevent these types of incidents from happening in the future. Now, the company believes the issue is limited, but they do recommend staying vigilant and keeping an eye out for suspicious activity or phishing attempts. Now, the disclosure, once I read it, I thought this is kind of vague. Discord did not mention who their third-party provider is, though some users online named a provider for these customer service tickets. We also do not know how many users are actually affected and for what time period. For instance, if you had contacted Discord in February, was your information exposed? We don't really know. Discord said that the risk is limited, but it is still wise to be on alert if your email address was indeed exposed. Hey, I'm Shannon Morse. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on the internet.